As drilling of oil production takes shape, oil waste management facilities are being put in place, while others are already in place to manage oil drill wastes from Tilenga and Kingfisher projects, according to Solomon Muyita, the Energy Ministry spokesperson.
So a lot of hazardous waste that is generated has to be managed in a proper recommended way, as you know, as it has been done elsewhere in the world by the countries that have been in this business of drilling and you know, dealing in oil and gas operations. So this is very key in the operations. The hazards have to be managed.
Environmentalists and scientists are in fear that oil and gas exploration and development will cause disruption of migratory pathways and degradation of important animal habitats and human life. However, Muyita says environmental precautions will be followed and people should not worry because government has acquired waste management facilities that are internationally certified.
It can handle these emergencies whenever they come. So people should not worry about anything. They should not worry. We are ready. We've been planning this for more than 15 years and here we are. The facilities are here. The people can see the facilities. We've been speaking to the experts and these are highly trained, specialized people. We have Ugandans trained, but we also have Ugandans working with people who have been doing the same in other countries. So we are in the right place.
Maybe could the last.
We are going to get a high density polyethylene. This is a product, we are not making it right now in the country. But I'm happy that if our petrochemical is going to be here, we are going to have a lot of them. Because it's part of the oil
byproduct.
All these are going to be the product. So we shall be making a lot of some of these. This item. So we shall get HDPE weather 1.5 or 2 millimeter. We cover it all.
The government has also put in place robust policies to ensure that oil and gas activities mutually coexist with the environment. Plus, social well-being of communities, highly trained people are available to do the required job.
Taking the landfill down there. And in the landfill, that's where we put solid waste after it has been treated. But we don't put solid waste with a lot of water content or moisture in it. So if we check with our machine there, and it gives us an indication that it's too much water or moisture, we have to absorb that excess water before it is put in the landfill.
Following the announcement of the final investment decisions for Uganda's flagship oil and gas projects, Uganda expects to receive its first oil in 2025. Report compiled by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news.